This is not to stigmatize the Jemaah Tabligh group, but this is for health issues that we need to have their collaboration to come forward, and that then we can actually do the necessary testing. In Ministry of Health, we need to find them, we need to test them, we need to isolate them, and we need to treat them. So far, we were informed that there's 14,500 local participants, local Jemaah Tabligh, and 1,500 from 25 countries. And we have managed to trace 11,000 of them. And out of 11,000, we have done a sampling for almost 6,700. And out of that, the positive is only 743, which means 1 out of 10 members confirmed positive. But now we are concerned because the spread may be among the members. So we have engaged with the leaders of Jemaah Tabligh, and on the 15th of February, I personally engaged with them, and we try to convince them, explain to them the issues and the challenges, and therefore have a full cooperation with them, and hopefully they are willing to step forward. Now, for asymptomatic, if you follow the guidelines from the World Health Organization, they only screen positive symptom, symptomatic patient. Then they only screen and or close contact. These are the two groups. But we have taken one step further than the guidelines from WHO. That is, we also screen the negative patient if they have a close contact, or a reason for us to believe that they have exposed to a positive patient. What we are doing, we are moving towards phase four, that is actually mitigation phase. So it's very important for us to make sure that this is a small window of opportunity for us to break, in terms of the transmission of the virus in the community. Setakat ni, satu hari kita boleh melaksanakan 3,500 ujian. Dan kita jangkakan minggu depan kita akan meningkat kepada 7,000 ujian sehari. Dan pada bulan April, masuk bulan April, kita jangkakan kita dapat melaksanakan 16,000 ujian sehari. Jadi kalau kita ada kemampuan melaksanakan ujian, jadi kita akan mengesan dan uji, uji dan uji untuk mengesan. Dan once confirmed, baru kita asingkan dan kita beri rawatan. But on the hospital, we are trying to enhance our healthcare facilities. And we have 26 hospitals that has already been identified. And in terms of the other services, and we are just focusing on COVID-19. But what is more important is that we are also managed to source for equipment. And we have added 6 more hospitals, that is a hybrid hospital, both, to treat COVID as well as other cases, that emergency cases, for example. Now, in terms of workers, in terms of human resource, we are trying to redeploy our medical officers, our staff nurses from other states to, for example, a high turnover or high load of patients of COVID in Sungai Buloh Hospital. That is one. And we also beginning to rehire our retirees, for example, nurses and our specialists and etc. coming back to serve us.